Hairdressing did not emerge as a profession until the reign of Louis XV of France and the influence on hair fashions by his mistress, Madame de Pompadour. Wig makers were prominent before this time but no hairdressers. Elaborate theme parties were thrown by socialites of the French court. Women started hiring artists to create hairstyles depicting the theme of these parties. The hair was draped over a frame stuffed with cotton, wool, or straw and cemented with a paste that hardened. The hair was then powdered and decorated. Hairdos had live birds in cages, waterfalls, cupids, and naval battles, complete with ships and smoke. One widow, overcome with mourning, had her husband's tombstone erected in her hair. This time in history is where the term hairdresser was born. They dressed the hair with ornamentation. By 1767 there were 1,200 hairdressers working in Paris. A few years earlier there had been none. Problems were many during this time. Women developed backaches from the weight of these monstrosities. They traveled 4 miles by carriage to these parties, bent over in the coach because their hair would not travel upright. The combination of being corseted and wearing bustiers added to the discomfort. The pomades to hold these styles together were made of beef lard and bear grease. Because these women paid a high dollar amount for the hairdos, they kept them for a week or two. The hair became rotten and would often attract vermin while the mistress slept. That is where the term, her hair is a rat's nest, originated. French perfumes became renowned to cover the smell of the rotting pomades.